Today, live, we're going to discuss money and first grade again. And happy Earth Day! Go hug a tree. All right, our goal is still 1.MD.5. Identify quarters, dimes, nickels, and pennies. Relate their value to pennies. The last 2 days, we've really talked about identifying these coins, what their values are, and talking about characteristics. Today, we're going to really focus on this part. We're going to relate the value of the quarter, the dime, and the nickel to pennies. So are you ready to subitize? All right, let me get our music on. Here we go. What do you see? Did you say 10? Good job. Here's the next one. 6 and 2 more. That's 8. Good job. What do you see? 10 and 3 more? Could that be 13? What do you see? 10 and 8 more? 18. Good job, guys. So we're going to move on. I'm going to hit escape. And we're going to talk about, I know that looks weird that we've got a cat on there. Stick with me. So let's first look right here before we talk about the cats. Each one of these trays has a number in it. We have the number 1, the number 25, the number 10, and the number 5. Each number represents the objects that's in there. Now, each object's not the same, but they all have the same value. So let's look at this right here. This might help you. We're going to make a connection with the cat video and numbers. This is the word cat, C-A-T, right? Now, cats can look like this. A cat can look like this. A cat can be a bobcat. A cat can be a mountain lion. Wolf. And a cat can be a lion. But C-A-T is just the word or symbol that represents these animals. So when you're reading to know what kind of cat you're talking about, you have to really look at the picture or have more details. And that's the same with our numbers. So let's look at the number 1. Digits are numerals. Numerals are written symbols that represent numbers. So this is the number 1. 1 has 1 digit. It is the numeral that represents the number value of 1. So in here we have different objects that represent 1. They have the value of 1. 1 counter, 1 button, 1 penny that's worth 1 cent, 1 square, and a 10 frame with 1. Now, I'll take my penny out, move that to the side. Let's look at the number 5. Number 5 is also a 1 digit number. 5 is the numeral that represents the number value of 5. So it also, each object in here, it's not the same 5, is it? No, but they all have the same value of 5. I have 5 pennies, 5 dots on a dice, a nickel that's worth 5 cent, 5 buttons, and 5 counters. So I'm going to take my coins out because we're going to play some games. I hope you brought your coins with you today. We're going to have some fun. Let's look at our next number, the number 10. The number 10 is a 2-digit number. 10 is the numeral that represents the number value of 10. 1 is a digit, and 0 is a digit within the numeral 10. And each one of these objects that you see represent the number 10. They all have the same value. So I have 10 pennies, 1 dime that equals 10 cent, 10 counters, 10 buttons, a 10 rod. Remember when we did place value, 10 rods are made up of 10 1 cubes. And I also have 10 cubes. And then I also have a 10 frame. I'll take my money out of here. our last number that we're going to talk about and look at is the number, what did you say? Did you say 25? That's right. That's the number 25. 25 also has two digits. The two digits are 2 and 5 that represent the number value of 25. 2 and 5 are also digits within the numeral. You can also compose 25 as 20 and 5 more. Remember how we did that? 20 and 5 more. Or two tens, two groups of 10, and 5 more. So each one of the objects in here has the same value as 25, but they're not all the same. Is this penny the same as our counters over here or the buttons? No, but they all have the same value. They're all equal, meaning same value. So I have 25 pennies, 2 quarters, 20, not 2 quarters, 1 quarter, sorry. 1 quarter, which equals the value of 25. I have 25 buttons, 25 counters, and 2 dimes and 5 pennies, which is the same as saying 2 groups of 10 and 5 left over. But we will not be worrying about counting our coins and adding up coins together. All we're doing is we're looking at the value of those coins and their relationship to a penny. So how many pennies do I need to make a nickel? How many pennies do I need to make a dime? How many pennies do I need to make a quarter? So let's look. The first one I have says a penny. And I want to show you something right fast. Look at this. My sticky notes were kind of sticking up, and that's okay. 0, 1 and 1, 0 is not the same. What's in this place? A 0. What's in this place? A 1. And here, a 1. And here, the 0. So this is 1 cent and this is 10 cent. There is a difference. So this one, 1 cent. What coin could I use to make 1 cent? I'm waiting. Anybody? Did you say a penny? You're right. A penny is 1 cent. Let's go with our 10 cent. If I have 10 cents, which coin can I put to represent 10 cent? Yes, I can use the dime, but what else could I use? Could I use a quarter? No. Could I use, did you say 10 pennies? Oh my goodness, you're so smart. So there's 2, 4, 6, 8. There's 10. So 1 dime is the same or has the same value as 10 pennies. Because is this dime the same as a penny? No, 2 different things, but their value, 10 cent, 10 cent. Yeah. So let's look at our nickel. Our nickel is wrote decimal 0.05. So if I want to take my coins and represent 5 cent, which coin was it that was worth 5 cent? I heard it. A nickel. Now, how many pennies would I need to also have the same value as this nickel? If you said 5, you would be correct. And my last coin, I'm running out of table here, but it's okay. My last coin that I have and that we're going to talk about before we start our games is 25 cents. If I have 25 cents, which coin can I put over here to represent 25 cents? Would I put a nickel? No. Would I put 1 penny? No. Can I put 25 pennies? I sure can, and take my word, that's 25 pennies, promise. That's 25 pennies, and 25 pennies has the same value as 1 quarter. Go. Now, I have a very fun game for you. You might want to come over here so you can get the game. All right, I'm going to take my money. I'm going to put it in a pile right here.
I'm going to put these back over here. We're going to play another game in a little bit. We're going to go grocery shopping. Oops. We're going to play store in a minute. So, parents, you can very easily make this. Just take a coloring page out of one of your children's coloring books and make it into a piggy bank. I drew this pig. It's okay, whatever you can do to help them. Then sticky notes, paper, make you some little cards for this game. So what you do is you take the card and you put it in a piggy bank. And your child has to decide, what does this say? Well, it says 10 cents. Then they put 10 cents into the piggy bank. They can put one dime is 10 cents. What else has the same value as one dime? Oh, what do you think? What makes 10? What do I have here that I could put 10 together to make one of these? Did you say pennies? Did I hear somebody say pennies? All right, count with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 pennies makes the same, has the same value as one dime. So now I scoot it off, and then I go to the next one. And you can turn these over, make it like a game. Now look at this. Is this 10 cents? No, I can't trick you. That's 1 cent. So which coin had the value of one? You're right. A penny has the value of 1 cent. Let's keep going. You're doing great. Sorry that my dog's barking again. I hope it's not as loud as yesterday. I moved her. All right, what is the value on this one? 25 cents? So, let's pretend that I do not have a quarter, because we know a quarter's worth 25 cents. What could I put in there? Did I hear 25 pennies? Good job. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. There are my 25 pennies that has the same value as 1 quarter. Now, could I put the quarter in there with it too? Would that be 25 cents? That would be a big whopping. No, you can take those 25 pennies away and you have 1 quarter that equals 25 cents. So 25 pennies and a quarter have the same value. Let's do another one. What's this one say? 5 cents. So which coin has the same value as 5 cents? This is the written form of 5 cents. Did you say a nickel? A nickel does have the value of 5 cents, the same value. I could also put how many pennies? Would I put 10? No. Would I put 25? No, that'd be too many, silly Miss Huffman. How many would I put? I would put 5. Look alive, number 5. Let's do another one. Ooh, is this a penny? Is this 1 cent? No, it's 10 cents, silly goose. 10 cents, so I can represent that 10 cents with one dime because that's the same value as this written symbol that this dime has value of. Or I can put 10 pennies. There's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 pennies has the same value as a dime. 10 pennies can be represented by the symbol 10 cents. All right, we only got 3 more, and then we're going to move on to our grocery store game. It's really fun. Now, this is written out 1 cent. 1 cent. Is this 1 cent?
Did I hear a no?
Okay, I'll try again. Is that 1 cent?
No! Silly Miss Huffman can't trick you. That penny has the same value as 1 cent. And no other coin has that value.
Let's look at this one.
These are the symbols for 5 cent.
5 cent.
What can I put for 5 cent? Did I hear nickel?
You would be correct.
What else has the same value as a nickel that I can put together and put in my piggy bank?
Did you say 5 pennies?
Oh, good job. Five pennies is the same value as 5 cent and a nickel. Here's our last one. This is written 25 cents. Which coin had the value of 25?
Oh, I know.
It's this dime, right?
No.
Oh, man, I can't trick you. I hear you screaming, quarter! So there's the quarter. He has the same value as 25 cents. I can also put 25 pennies. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. And that's good practice for your counting as well. So 25 pennies has the same value as 25 cents or 1/4. Now, here's another game that you can play with your kids. And I had to take my pig down. He wouldn't stay on the tape. He wouldn't stay flat. He was curved. Oops, I'm ripping him. I was hoping to keep him. We'll have to doctor him up later. So I'm going to move that out of the way. Now, another game that you can do with your kids, keep you moving. I know during this quarantine time, I get tired of sitting. So, I took sticky notes and just different objects, and I wrote 1 cent, 5 cent, 25 cents, and 10 cent on the object. And you can give your child, like, look, I know everybody has the pickle jar in your house, or some kind of jar that has money in it. Play with the money. So, give your children some money, and even the little ones can do this, like if you have a kindergartner, it's good practice for them. And they go around and you play grocery store, or you play Dollar General or Walmart or whatever that store they want to make it to be. So, if they want to buy an object, they have to give you the same value in coins as the symbols that are written in money form on the object. For example, this pencil is just a whopping penny. I mean, who couldn't buy a pencil for a penny? So your child would give you a penny and tell you that 1 penny has the same value as 1 cent. Then you could move on to a marker. I mean, who doesn't want a double-sided marker for 10 cent? I mean, love it. It's been a lifesaver in my world right now. So you would discuss with your child, what coins would I use, coin or coins, could I use to buy this object for 10 cent? They would tell you a dime has the same value as 10 cent. Or they might say, I don't have a dime, but I have pennies. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And 10 pennies just bought them a nice green and blue marker. We can move on. A glue stick. Now this is a brand new glue stick for 25 cents. Today only. Again, you would do that same process where they would tell you which coin has the same value as the written form and symbols of 25 cents. Or they could count out the 25 pennies. And our last object. Who doesn't love a magnet clip? It's a whopping 5 cents today. So, who can tell me what coins I can put together to make this purchase? Did I hear 5 pennies? Good job. 5 pennies will buy that clip because they have the same value as 5 cents. Ooh, yes, yes, you can buy it with a nickel because a nickel has the same value as that 5 cents. So guys, I hope you enjoyed the video today. I hope you have lots of fun with these two games. Very simple to make, gets you up, gets you doing something. Also has very good practice in it for your math and money skills. I love you guys. I will be back next week. I'm not sure which days. I will let my parents know. But Miss Ramsey will be with you tomorrow doing more math. I love you, love bugs. Miss you much. Mwah.